We take no prisoners, leave nothing, only ghosts creeping down the Silk Road from the third world to the fucked up world. Kill everything that moves.
Empire, empire, or humanity? Humanity. Empire, empire, or humanity? Humanity. What the Classroom Didn't Teach Me About the American Empire, by Howard Zinn. With an occupying army waging war in Iraq and Afghanistan, with military bases and corporate bullying in every part of the world, there is hardly a question anymore of the existence of an American empire. Empire. Even as I began to have second thoughts about the purity of the good war, even after being horrified by Hiroshima and Nagasaki, even after rethinking my own bombing of towns in Europe, I still did not put all that together in the context of an American empire. Empire. Or humanity. Humanity. I was conscious, like everyone, of the British Empire and the other imperial powers of Europe. But the United States was not seen in the same way. U.S. history. Empire. I usually found a chapter in the history text called The Age of Imperialism, with only a relatively few years. I recall the classroom map labeled Western Expansion, the natural, almost biological phenomenon, vacant land acquired. Empire. What we now call ethnic cleansing. Humanity. The term manifest destiny became more universal. Within a natural sphere of U.S. interest, the Louisiana Purchase, Mexican Cession, the invasion of Cuba, the invasion of the Philippines, halfway around the world. The word imperialism now seemed a fitting one for U.S. actions. Reading outside the classroom, I began to fit the pieces of history into a larger mosaic. Empire. A succession of violent interventions. The years after World War II, the world's leading superpower, determined to maintain and expand empire, taking over remote islands in the Pacific. The war in Korea, 1950, the covert intervention in Vietnam, the imperial designs of the United States, the desire of empire. Humanity. Part of a grander imperial design, to establish its dominance everywhere. Manifest destiny. Empire or humanity? Given the history of the United States, it is not hard to decide that question. Empire, empire, or humanity? Humanity. Empire, empire, or humanity? Humanity. More than 700 American military bases outside of the United States. War on terrorism. Manifest destiny. Many more bases have been established or expanded. When I was bombing cities in Germany, Hungary, Czechoslovakia, and France in the Second World War, the moral justification was so simple and clear as to be beyond discussion. We were saving the world from the evil of fascism. I was therefore startled to hear from a gunner on another crew that he considered this an imperialist war. Both sides, he said, were motivated by ambitions of control and conquest. We argued about it without resolving the issue. Ironically, not long after our discussion, this fellow was shot down and killed on a mission. In wars, there is always a difference between the motives of the soldiers and the motives of the political leaders who send them into battle. The rhetoric, often persuasive on first hearing, soon becomes overwhelmed by horrors that can no longer be concealed. The bloody corpses of Iraq, the torn limbs of American GIs, the millions of families driven from their homes, in the Middle East and in the Mississippi Delta. Have not the justifications for empire so embedded in our culture and assaulting our good sense that war is necessary for security, that expansion is fundamental to civilization, begun to lose their hold on our minds? Have we not reached a point in history where we are ready to embrace a new way of living in the world, expanding not our military power, but our humanity? Empire, empire, or humanity? Humanity. 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 manifest destiny, expansion in the Middle East and elsewhere, quote-unquote war on terrorism, empire.